Grandma has a new roommate. Well, earlier I caught up with Dr. Dar to chat about the new trend of cohabitation among the older set. Welcome back to Fox News Rising. Well, when you mention living together, some older people frown up. But a new study says it's the older ones who are cohabitating just like the younger generation. Dr. Dar is here with us this morning to tell us what this is all about. Good morning to you, Dr. Dar. Now, this comes from a recent study. Kind of tell us about where this topic even really originates from.
Well, there's a lot of studies right now observing what's going on with the boomer generation. Obviously, it's the largest generation and population of people in our country. And so there's lots of studies around their spending patterns, marketing. What are they, what are they watching? What are they going to buy as a result of watching that or reading it? And also, what are their living behaviors?
So living in sin, as
right.
we like to hear, which obviously has a religious undertone to it that, you know, parents are often worried about when it comes to their kids. We want you to be married, and that's when you live together, and then that's when the family comes together. So why is it okay for this generation to now do this? What do you think has changed?
I think there's two scenarios at play here. There's divorce. I mean, there's an increasing number of baby boomers who are reaching their 50s, 60s, and even 70s, finding themselves not knowing their partner and choosing to leave the relationship. Maybe they chose to stay for the children. Maybe they just don't know each other anymore and they've got issues that they can't resolve. In addition to that, death, you know, being a widow and wanting to have companionship is also a result of that. But more importantly, I think that there's a lot of risk today in committing financially, emotionally, and, you know, physically to a person and merging everything that you own in with another party, as in getting married. And I think they really just want companionship more than anything, and marriage is more of a secondary thought.
Now, does this seem like it's more friendship, or does this seem like this really is a love interest that they're deciding to cohabitate with?
It's really a love interest.
Okay.
Yes. In some cases, I mean, I'm sure there's a small percentage where it's a mutually beneficial arrangement, but most of the time it's love interest.
So how do we explain this to the kids and their kids?
What I'm saying is they're not really explaining it. They just say we're moving in together, and the children are saying, well, that's kind of hypocritical, don't you think? You didn't let me do it. But then over time, the children see that, okay, this is the best thing. It's the best thing for the family assets, so to speak, and it's the best thing for families to check each other out, and I like to call it sniff each other out before a longer term commitment's made where assets are merged.
Well, and you know your loved one has someone there kind of protecting them too, or at least along the journey with them.
That's true too.
Now, you know, as a relationship expert, what are the negatives with this? Because, you know, when we hear about it, living in sin, it seems like it's a no-no for every age limit, you know, every age that's out there. So what do you think are the true negatives at this point in life?
Aside from the religious views, which is really the main reason why there's negativity around living together, I'm actually a proponent of it. And the reason why, and I'm a proponent of it as long as there's a cohabitation agreement in place. And what that means is discussions and agreements about who's going to pay which bills, you know, who's going to pay the mortgage. If somebody gets hurt and is unable to work for an extended period of time, how are you going to handle that? What about assets that you're bringing into the relationship? How are you going to address that? I think that's just good. It's good business, and it's good to do that in a relationship.
So do you see this trend continuing?
Do
you see even, you know, your age and, you know, my age kind of transitioning into this too, possibly as we get older as well?
I do. I really do. And I think it really just helps people be more firm in their commitment, be more certain when they're making that committed choice, because, you know, there are a lot of marriages ending today.
Right.
And the reason why is people get into them even up to the day of the wedding, not 100% certain. And so I think this gives them a little bit more flavor of what it would be like in order to be certain.
Anything else we should know if we've got, you know, possibly our grandparents or parents doing the same thing? Any way we should approach the situation if we do have questions?
I think it's important to ask them about the cohabitation agreement and what kind of agreements are you making so that you don't get in trouble as a parent. It's really difficult for a child to have that, but they need to do that. And also, when the intimacy, boomers, you know, talking to our parents about safe sex, I mean, we need to do that. We need to do that.
It's because coming to the point where it's important to them, too.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's
well,
right.
Thank you so much for joining us here.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thank
have a great
you.
Weekend.
You too.